To the guy in my closet, let me start by saying you probably don't have AIDS. It was 3 days ago that I came home early in the afternoon.
Hello? I'm home early from work, babe.
As I stepped into the apartment, I heard what could best be described as mediocre sex coming from my bedroom. I deduced logically that the chances of some happily adventurous couple breaking into my house for some quick copulation were slim. I knew it was my girlfriend cheating on me, which I had long suspected. Your oafish grunts were so loud I could barely make my presence known.
Honey! Oh, honey! Honey! I'm home! I'm home! I'm home!
Get in the closet.
When I walked into the bedroom, my girlfriend was still getting into the bed from putting you in the closet. I could see the sweat on her, despite her trying to look like she was relaxing. I asked her about the nightie she was wearing. She said it was the most comfortable thing she could find.
I thought I heard something out in the hallway.
Oh, I was watching TV.
Oh, quick side note. I'm not sure how many affairs you participate in, but a word of advice. When you hide in the closet from an angry boyfriend, make sure a few toes aren't sticking out of the bottom of the door. At this point, I'm in a bit of a predicament. I could have the typical masculine response. And beat the living shit out of you. But then you might file charges, and quite frankly, I don't care enough. Not to mention I don't know how big you are, and I can't think of anything worse than finding your girlfriend cheating on you, followed swiftly by getting pummeled by her new lover. I thought of having marathon sex with her while you stand and watch from the tidy closet you were in, but the fact that she's such a dirty whore grossed me out a little. I also considered just sitting around jerking it for a while. But I'm glad I went with something else. So, I sat her down, told her I'd just been to the doctor. Somberly, I looked deep into her eyes and informed her that
I've been diagnosed with early stages of the HIV virus.
Recently, I had a string of bad luck in the way of a few colds back to back. She believed it. You believed it. As you know, the whole thing took about 2 hours and involved a lot of yelling, accusing, and crying.
You can be accusing me of anything when you're the one that's telling me that you have a disease?
Still, I felt I hadn't punished you enough. I told her the illness is making me tired and that I need to lay down.
I'm calling for Dr. Silverstein.
I could hear her making doctor's appointments for herself, all the while, stealing glances at the closet as we both heard you rustling around in there. I have to say, you did a pretty good job holding still, as I'm sure you aren't used to standing perfectly straight in a 3x4 closet for 5 hours. But if I hadn't known you were there, you'd have been caught for sure.
It's very important.
After some more time passed, after thinking about more what to do next, I realized you actually might be innocent. What if you didn't know she had a boyfriend? But I mean, what if you did? I just couldn't know. After a little while longer, I decided I ultimately felt a little sorry for you. So I pretend to go to the drugstore to pick up a prescription so you could leave. I actually felt a little guilty about it later. So I'm writing this letter, and hopefully you'll find it as a relief. I wouldn't mind taking you out for a drink, actually. After all, I had quite a bit of fun and no longer have to deal with her cheating on me. So thank you. P.S. You might actually want to get checked out. Because after all, my girlfriend was a dirty whore.
She's a ghetto woman, waiting for a man to come home.